So suppose you want to combine different images into a single image. This is something you can easily do in Photoshop or some other kind of graphic software. But let's say you just wanted to do it using what you have on your Mac by default, like the Preview app. So you can open up images in the Preview app pretty easily. You can select images. I'm going to select four of them here and you can drag them to Preview, or I'm just going to double click to open them automatically in Preview since that's the default app for me. And you can see I've got four images now. They're in a sidebar. It doesn't matter if they open in a sidebar or in four separate windows. This works regardless. So fortunately there's no way to start a new blank document in Preview. I really feel this is something Apple needs to add, but until then it's pretty easy to get around it. All you need to do is basically have something that you copy to the buffer and then you can create a new image from that. Now these images are almost all the same size. This one right here is a little different, so we'll deal with that later. But let's select one here that this is a 4000 by 3000 pixel image. I'm going to click in the image itself and then do Command C to copy. The reason I want to do that is because if I click here, I'm actually copying the file, not the image inside. Now I'm going to go to File, New from Clipboard. And this will create a new Preview document that has that same thing in it. But I'm instantly going to do Command A and then Delete to clear it out. So now I have a 4000 by 3000 image. It's blank. Perfect. This is what I want. Now I want to put all four images in here. So that means reducing the size of each by half. I can actually click on an image like this first one here, click in here, do Command A to select all, copy, go over here and paste, but I get back what I just had, something that's full size. So I'm going to undo, go back here, and before I do the copy I'm actually going to go in and go to Tools, Adjust Size, and I'm going to cut it down in half. So instead of 4000 pixels wide, I'm going to make it 2000 pixels wide, hit OK. Now I'll do Command A to select all, Command C to copy, go over here and paste it in. And now I've got this half size image here which I can place in the upper left hand corner. I'm going to do the same thing for the other images. So I'll go into this image here, Adjust Size, have the size, Command, click inside here and do Command A, Command C, and paste it in. And I'll put this here. And you can see that you even get alignment marks there to like align these to the center of each other. Let's go to the next one and have that. Click in it, Command A, Command C, and paste. And now I'll go to the last one here, and this one is a little bit different. Just to show you as an example, when I do Adjust Size, you see the sizes are different. If I do 2000 across, the height's going to be a bit short. So I'll make sure the height is full height and it's a little extra wide. So I'll do that. Click in there, Command A, Command C, and paste. And you can see this image is a little bit too big. I could just crop it off to the right there like that. But in this case, let's make it harder. I'll put it over there and it overlaps here. So you can't really move this on top of that. What I can do is Command C and then delete this image here with the delete key, and Command V to paste a new copy on top. So now they line up, and you could play around with the alignment if it's not quite perfect to get it so that it matches perfectly there. And now basically I've got what I wanted. So at this point I could go to File, Export, and save it out in as a JPEG if I wanted to, or I could have just hit Command S for save and it would have saved it as a PNG, which is the standard format for Preview images. So we'll save it out, and now I can close it, and of course it's going to ask me to delete this file because remember it's a PNG here, this document. I exported it as a JPEG, but that's fine for my purposes. Now I can double click on this JPEG, it opens up, and there's a JPEG image that has all four there. Very useful for doing things, say, inside of iMovie where you want to put four images in like that, or maybe making a single image post to a social media site. The one thing is because we have the size of all of these, and it's automatically saving documents as you work on them, you're going to want to go in, unless you don't care about these original images here. Maybe they're copies or something. You want to go and undo the size changes in them. So Command Z for each of these. Go back to the original size. So I just basically selected each one, did Command Z, and you can see the edited mark went away up there. Now I can close these and they're untouched originals, and I still have this